In that car.
Can I sit in it?
Sure.
Wow.
That was cheap.
It's got to be one of the most iconic movie cars of all
time. It is, by far.
Wow, what a beautiful day to be alive. Today we are traveling to Portland, Connecticut. For those of you in the car world, you've already figured out where I'm going. We're going to F40 Motorsports, visit Mr. Wayne Carini, an icon, a legend, the man in the business. We're going to try to buy some cars from him. Here we go.
They got rid of quickly. We got a bunch of the Grand Cherokees too.
Got a Grand Cherokee L.
The wagon.
It's fantastic. But I'm a Jeep Wrangler guy. Okay. I've got a Jeep. I've got a Grand Wagoneer and a Wagoneer coming in next week.
This is our only one right now.
Well, that'll work. It's a good color.
Yeah, I like that.
Sarge Green. I love the color.
Is that what it's called?
It's called Sarge Green.
It's a good name for it. Exactly what it makes me feel.
So we walked in and Ralph tried to give us a Tahoe, but he switches to a Wrangler. So thanks for that, sir. It matches your jacket.
Yeah, right, it does.
You didn't even know that, did you?
Yeah, wedding ring too, look at that.
Look at that. So we're here at the Goodwin in Hartford, Connecticut. Now we got to figure out how to get in this place. I stayed here one time before a couple years ago, and it was really weird. So let's go figure it out. So it's early 30. We stayed at the Goodwin last night. It's a boutique hotel in Hartford, Connecticut. And then we went to Max's downtown Chop House last night and had a 36-ounce Tomahawk, and it was outstanding. Now we're gonna go get in the Jeep and drive to Portland, Connecticut to see Wayne Carini's place, F40 Motorsports, and see some legendary cars. So get your cup of Joe and let's go. This is an exciting day. It's the third time I've been to Wayne's place. If you're a car guy, this is a must stop on your bucket list if you're ever in Portland, Connecticut, or in Connecticut for that matter. It's not very far from Hartford. I've got one I got my eye on I'm pretty sure I'm gonna buy today, and hopefully he's got something else in the back. Perhaps maybe just a project that he's not gonna get to. He's got some really neat stuff. Here we go. Too shabby. Good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
Great. What an incredible showroom.
Oh, thank you.
Super America, Bosworth 29, Dino. Wow. SS Jag and a 66 big wide Corvette. How are you?
Good. I'm Sue.
Dennis Collins.
Nice to meet you.
You too, man. We've been speaking on the phone about the Mercedes.
Yes.
We're here to see Wayne or Mike or whoever's available.
Okay. Let me get them for you.
Favorite cars, Super America.
You get Wayne?
Yeah.
Dennis.
Good morning, sir. How are you?
Nice to see you. Yeah, nice to see you.
You too. This is Zach.
Hey, Zach. How are you?
Good, good, good. So yeah. This is my whole crew right here.
Great. That's the way it should be.
It makes it easier.
Can we get you a coffee or a water?
Actually, I'm already coffeed up this
okay.
morning.
Awesome.
Even though I love coffee.
Yeah.
Showroom looks amazing.
Yeah,
I did.
Thank you.
SS Jag.
Yep, that's Wayne's.
66 big block Corvette.
What's happening, man?
Good morning, Wayne. How are you, sir?
I'm good. How are you?
Good, good. Thanks for having me.
Yeah.
How's everything?
Everything's great.
How was SEMA?
SEMA was fast.
Was it?
One day.
The second time I haven't gone.
Yeah.
I missed it twice the last 20 years.
There was quite a few no-shows. South Hall, in the lower level of South Hall, by when you stop at the Jeeps at that stairway.
Right.
That's it. That's all of downstairs at South Hall.
Well, my main business is Jeep stuff, and since the JL's already been out for 3 model years, it's just not a whole lot of reason for me to go.
Yeah.
And we normally build a few for some customers, but they were all building Broncos this year.
Yeah. Well,
I'm sure there was a ton of those there.
Yeah, lots of Broncos.
How was the crowd?
It was down.
It looked like it on, watching some social feeds. It looked like it was way down.
Yeah, it was. And it was a lot of empty spots. I did a signing for 2 hours at Craftsman, and there was 2 spots right around us. No one was there.
I've never seen
empty,
that.
Empty.
You know they had to pay for the spots.
Yeah.
Just decided not to go.
Yeah.
Well, I called Mike and asked him to hold that SLR you guys have listed.
Yeah. Let's show it to you.
I want to see it.
Come on. Let's go. Let's go take a peek.
And thanks for doing that.
Yeah. My pleasure.
So I'm actually chasing this car, pardon the pun, for my brother.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Oh, cool.
Just in all transparency. I'm not buying it, or he's not buying it to resell.
That's cool.
Look at that. See these on the streets.
I know. It's really unbelievable to think that it's such a
beautiful,
unbelievable car. You know, with that side exhaust coming out in front, that's so cool.
Have you driven it?
I have.
Okay.
It's really great. Yep.
Well, I was reading the stats on it. It says this car will break 200 miles an hour. Mm-hmm. 207, 208.
Yep.
The only car I've ever been over 200 miles an hour is an F50. It's not an F50. A 550 Maranello.
It's all right.
Yeah, that's the only car I've ever had that fast.
Well, I tried to go this year. I went to Bonneville, and unfortunately, we broke our transmission before we could go 200. So.
Really?
Yeah.
I actually ran Bonneville in my 550.
Did you?
Yeah. Wow. I did right at 203 out and 198 back. Just barely averaged over 200.
Cool.
So I did it.
Yeah?
Yeah. Got a flat tire.
Oh, my God.
It's rougher than you think.
Yeah.
You've run it, right?
No, I've never run it.
Yeah. It is not what you would think. It is rough.
Got a Bonneville car, but
it's hard on the car too.
I've got the old Tony Thacker Jimmy Shine car.
Really?
Yeah, 32 Ford. Yeah.
Yep, that's awesome.
Yeah. So yeah.
It's
a beautiful car in silver.
Yeah, I think that's the only color to have in this car.
Yeah, silver is it.
Have you ever had a Sterling Moss edition?
No.
The 722?
No.
Oh, man, those cars. We went to Saudi Arabia for that big show and saw 3 of them there. Those cars are stunning in person.
Is that right?
Yeah. Yeah. Absolutely incredible. So this is what it has, like 2,000 miles on it?
Yeah, just over 2,000 miles.
So I know they made it over the span of making these things from 03 to 10 or whatever, 03 to 9, or they made, what, like 2,157 of them?
Just over 2,000, yeah.
But how many were, most of those were coupes?
A lot of them
were coupes. A lot of them were coupes. You hardly ever see a convertible.
Yeah.
And to me, and you're probably going to cringe when I say this, I'd rather have a 300 SL than a Goldwing to drive.
Yeah, I know. Well, There's the
incredible
SL coupe, but to drive, they're much nicer car to drive. Like cooler. I mean, if you're going to go on a Colorado Grand
or
touring with it,
which is probably the ultimate tour for one of those cars.
It is.
No AC.
Yeah. No AC and no ventilation.
The reason he's watching this is he's the largest margarita manufacturer in Texas, but he invests in real estate.
Mm-hmm.
So he's been watching the supercars, which I guess. Arguably, that's not a supercar. A lot of the editors call it a GT car, Grand Touring car. What's your take?
I think it's a supercar. Okay. Listen, any car that's going to go over 200 miles an hour, it's a supercar.
Well, I mean, Mercedes and McLaren say it's a supercar, but a lot of the automotive writers say it's not. They put it in the class of like a 599 or something.
There's more articles coming out that are going against that. Yeah.
You think it's a supercar
like Manny,
too?
I don't know if you follow Manny in California.
He
has 7 of them. And he's like, a lot of these guys are pushing.
Listen, piston-driven cars are going to become a thing of the past. Piston driven supercars.
That's crazy.
You know, so everybody's going to that electric mode. You know, Corvette, Audi, everybody's going electric.
Yeah, even Copo's got an electric drag car.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
Yeah, it's gonna turn that way. So because of that,
I think these cars are undervalued.
They are. Absolutely.
I mean, if you look what came out in this era, you had Enzo and a Carrera GT, look what they've done.
That's right.
And these are just kind of, I think they bottomed out though.
They have, yeah.
I think this is the right time to buy.
Well, they were 500-600 new, and then they dropped and leveled, and now if you notice, they're on the rise.
The first two that I saw in Dallas brought 100 over sticker back in the day, which put them at what, 600-ish?
Yeah.
What's sticker on this one?
This was 500.
500?
Yeah, right at 500.
I mean, I would have kept it, except for he, you know, he doesn't let me keep it in there. He talks to me and he says, oh, geez, come on, let me sell that car.
Well, I called him and he said, Dennis, I've got like 10 or 11 guys in this car. I said, well, can you please call Wayne and see if he'll hold it?
Yeah, and I, you know, reluctantly, but.
Well, I appreciate that.
Whatever. We're car dealers.
That's right.
There's certain cars, so I've got my CTSV wagon up there. That's a keeper for a while. That's got 9,000 miles on it.
Stick shift wagon.
And I'm buying these Mustangs now. So the GT350Rs.
Okay.
I buy them just like that, right in the wrapper.
Right in the wrapper.
Just put it up there so I don't use it.
I had 42 Fox bodies at one time, and the parameters on that, they were all one owner. They all had original tires.
Wow.
And all but maybe four of them had less than 10,000 miles, and about 10 of them were new.
So this has got 6 miles on it.
Yeah, the short mile stuff's great.
6 miles, and I got a 500 at home that's got 8 miles on it.
Wow, well if I run across it with no miles, I'll call you.
Yeah, yeah, I'm looking for a Heritage.
Okay.
With no miles.
I've been back and putting my Jeep collection back together again. Well, back to this. Looks condition-wise incredible.
Yeah, it is. There's really nothing wrong with it. No door dings, scuffs.
Gas. Stunning car.
Key in it, Mike?
Yeah, key should be in it.
And the doors do this.
That's right.
2,125 miles.
They're almost golden, right? Where's the...
There you go.
Wow. And that's kind of cool.
That is really cool.
The bonnet lifts.
A little complicated.
And what's really cool is where the engine sits. So far back.
Do they push? When you drive them, if you drive it hard?
No.
Not really?
No. I mean, look at the suspension. Look at the sway bar. They got this balance so well.
Somebody did a killer detail, too. It was fantastic.
Yeah, well, it's a no miles car, but yet. You
know. Is it serviced or ready to go?
It could use a service.
Okay.
It could use a service.
Yeah, it's been the showroom piece most of its life, sitting.
Well, then we'll bring it back and have it serviced before he drives it.
Yeah, just probably going to have to find the Mercedes dealer that handles the McLaren.
I actually know who it is.
Okay, good.
Jed Siddle will take care of me.
Okay, cool.
Good guy. So this is 1804, and there was like 2157 total. I think there was only 500 roadsters.
It sounds about right, yeah.
What a cool car. Well, can we drive it or hear it run? Yeah.
Let's put a plate on it and let's go.
Okay.
You see what's sitting next to it? That's the Hirahata Mercury. The famous Barris car.
Wow. You know, last time I was here, you showed me that center steer Corvair truck.
Yeah, it's down the Lane Museum now.
Oh my God, I wanted that thing so bad.
I restored that and Jeff Lane bought it from me.
Oh, you did restore it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, fully restored it.
That thing was so cool.
Brought it to Amelia Island this past year and I parked next to Jeff. By the time the day was over, he owned it.
Really?
Yeah.
That was really, really cool. I couldn't get that one out of my mind. I was like, I gotta buy that car.
Yeah.
That's why he goes, no, he sold it, it's gone.
Yeah. Sold it to Jeff, and it's at the right place too, you know, in that museum.
Oh, absolutely.
You know, they'll be able to show it and enjoy it.
What do you think about Testarossa, Mark? Well, that's changed in the last 9 months, hasn't
it? That's right. That's coming up, so we just picked that one up. Yeah, that and the 328 market is strong still.
Yes.
This one's got some miles on it. That's my car up there. It's got 7,000 miles on it.
all the Ferrari stuff finally came around.
Yeah.
It just got too cheap.
It did. Now it's, people are waking up.
Yeah. And what I'm really surprised is that the boxers haven't come up higher than they have.
Yeah, I know, but you know, boxers is, it's not a young man's supercar, you know. They gotta look like this.
Yeah. You know? Well, but
it's sort of in the middle from a vintage. I mean, I love boxers.
I do too.
Mike just sold mine. Matter of fact, that was a keeper too. And Mike talked me into selling that. We had a blue one with a cream interior. It was beautiful.
Ooh, that's rare.
Yeah.
But how do you explain the value differential between a Miura and a boxer? Mm-hmm.
That's a toss-up.
Because I've owned them both.
Yeah.
And I don't see the Miura being that far superior to a boxer as a driving car.
It's a more balanced car because of the transverse engine. Where the Ferrari can get a little tail happy, you go around,
right.
You know, on a racetrack. You know, once you get that momentum going around in the back, it's hard to control it. Where the Miura is more of a balanced car. That's what I see. It.
But the prices of them just
it's just crazy.
I sold my last Miura for $385.
Wow. You should have had that. Yeah. Like you have that one back.
It's obviously been a while. Oh, that was a disaster. It recently sold for, I think the last time it sold was for 1.6. I think boxers are cheap.
They are. They are.
It's a neat car.
They are. You know, you can buy one under $300,000. You know?
Yeah. Oh, I still see them for under that.
Yeah.
It's got carbon ceramic brakes.
It's got it all.
Incredible.
Look at the size of the brakes.
I mean, it's just got, I mean, it is a supercar.
Absolutely.
You have McLaren involved, you have AMG involved, and Mercedes involved. That's the only time that's happened, I think.
It is.
Probably won't happen again either.
No. Well, Mike, with electric, who knows? I'm not totally against it, but I'm not seeing the immediate future in that. All these charging stations, how's that going to come around?
Well, here's my take on it. I'm not a fan, but so our grid in Texas for electricity, we couldn't handle this winter. It got shut down multiple times.
I remember, yeah.
So we were going to plug these cars in.
That's right.
And then Tesla is moving their plant to Austin, Texas to build them.
Right.
We don't have any power to plug them in. So how's that going to work, people?
It's not going to work. In California, there's brownouts.
Yeah, all the time.
You can't turn your air conditioning on for only so many hours a day and stuff.
That's,
and what's
going to
happen when everybody plugs their car in?
I have two generators being installed in my house next week.
Yeah.
Because power keeps going on.
Well, I love the picture of the Tesla charging stations, and then behind it, and behind a shrubbery, is a cat generator.
Right.
Supplying power to the charging stations.
Or the Tesla truck that rescues the cars when their batteries go dead.
Right.
Yeah. The generator in the back is running with diesel.
Yeah.
You're like, come on, people, wake up.
Yeah.
Let's take this thing out.
Yeah, let's do it.
You know, this thing is, I haven't seen one in a while. This thing is stunning in person.
It is. Wow. Really great, long nose.
I may just have to keep this for myself and not let my brother have it. I don't think he'd be very happy. Okay. Carbon fiber seats.
So you got to turn the key.
Okay. Really smarter than the car, huh?
Yeah.
So have you spent much time in this car?
No.
Or in one of these? No?
I drove it home once. That was it.
Is that it?
Yep.
Okay. Well, it needs a gurney bubble.
Yeah, that's right.
My hair's touching the roof.
I think you can put that seat down a little bit.
Boy, it's long, isn't it?
Yes, it is. Yeah, that nose is really long. We can go out here and follow traffic that way.
Okay. That's where you use it to do your test drives.
That's right, right here.
So I have to say, I know you hear this all the time, but your show is definitely my favorite car show of all time.
Oh, thank you. You guys did good for a long time.
Yeah, you have. How many seasons have you done?
17.
Wow. So it's got an active rear spoiler too, huh?
Yep.
I like that it's heavy steer.
Yeah, well, you can feel it's a real car. Some of these things, they feel like you're driving a Honda Accord.
Yeah, this is actually has real leather everywhere.
That's right.
Kind of disappointing driving a new Porsche. Have you driven them?
Yeah.
There's so much plastic in it.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
A lot of plastic. We just took a 2019 Turbo cabin. I drove it, and I said, maybe I could use this for the summer. This is a kind of cool car. I drove it up to Dunkin' Donuts here, drove it back. I gave the keys to Mike. I said, sell it. Not for me.
Speaking of Dunkin' Donuts, it's National Donut Day.
Is it?
Yes. Little piece of trivia. For those of you trying to figure out what time of year we filmed this.
We'll see if Dunkin' Donuts got a huge line or not.
What's your favorite car to drive?
Ever?
Ever.
1960 250 short wheelbase. We can keep going straight.
Okay. Well, I've never had the pleasure to drive a short wheelbase.
No, it's fabulous. 62. It's absolutely fabulous. I've been lucky enough to restore 8 of them.
I've watched several of the ones that you restored. Incredible.
Yeah.
You know, there's some guys out there making some incredible reproduction cow spiders now.
That's right. They are.
I mean, I looked at one recently that the guy owns a real one. So he had his car cloned so he could drive it.
Do it, sure.
It is perfect. It was exact.
I've got
absolutely
it.
Exact.
I've got a 250 DK Testarossa.
DK Engineering?
Yeah.
Okay.
Fabulous car. And I just bought a Persang. It's being delivered in California in December.
And that's the Bugatti replica.
Bugatti replica. Type
but you
51.
Can't, I mean, those things are perfect, right?
I got a Type 51. You can't even tell the difference, I'm telling you. It's that cool of a car.
I've seen those next to each other. I've always wanted to go there. Have you ever been to Christchurch?
No.
That's kind of on my bucket list.
Yeah.
I mean, that's some of the top coach builders in the world are there.
Yep.
I've seen some stuff coming out.
Yeah, they do amazing. Fabulous stuff. I'll show you a car later on that came out of there.
I saw there is a Dolomite that was around Dallas for a while.
Uh-huh.
That was done at Christchurch.
Yep.
And you could not tell. I mean, it was so
what
on
a beautiful
the money.
Car that is.
Beautiful.
How's it feel?
Feels great. It's tight. Nice car.
Yeah.
I drive this. My favorite driving car of all time is a 550 Maranello.
Those are cool. The one I really like, though, in my collection is my Shelby GT350. I got a 65. What a car.
Great car. Yeah. I've been buying and selling Shelbys my whole life. I'm actually, in the next 3 weeks, buying 3. Got a 67 GT350 of mine, a 67 GT500, and a one-owner GT500.
Wow.
Is this picture right here okay?
Yeah, we can just go up a little bit more. That's right.
Beautiful area.
It is, yeah. Matter of fact, we'll turn around up here in a really beautiful spot.
So what was your best find this year?
Oh, God, I found found another Stutz Bearcat.
I know you've always, those are fabulous cars. I know you've had quite a few of those.
Yep, yeah. With the Stutz Bearcat, I found a Edwards America. We're restoring for a guy named Gary Edwards. He says, find me an Edwards America.
Is that the one that looks kind of like a Nash Healey?
Yes.
Okay. I chased Nash Healeys for a long time.
Yeah, it looks like that, but it really looks like a Vignale because it was a Vignale design car.
Okay.
It was built by Mr. Edwards up in San Francisco, and he built 5 of them.
Kind of looks like a Cunningham, too.
Yes, Cunningham, yep.
How many Cunninghams have you had?
3.
That's incredible.
Yeah.
Oh, they're expensive now.
I'm into Allards right now.
I saw you driving that green one.
Yeah, I got 2. I just bought a J2 also.
Is that like driving a Cobra or something?
It is. It's a little wild. The green one's dangerous.
Wild.
It's got a 406 Ford NASCAR Hummel & Moody engine in it.
I saw you driving. I was like, wow, that thing looks like a handful.
Yeah, it is. It's got over 400 horsepower. They say 440. And it's got trips on it, and it flies. For that little car.
Yeah, that's cool.
You go, oh my God, hang on. And then the J2 I just bought's got a 331 Caddy in it. I like that car. I may sell the other one and keep the J2.
The 331 Cadillac motor's pretty neat.
Oh, they're nice. They sound so good.
My friend's still a guy, but a friend of mine and I, we went in halves on a car called a Joe Earns, mm-hmm. which is very similar looking to the Edwards or the Cunningham or Nash Healey's back in high school. It has 331 in it, it's still in there. That was a lot of fun.
Yeah.
This 600 horsepower is pretty cool. It's fast.
That'll do it.
It runs hard. Wow.
This needs to be out in Texas.
Yeah.
We got some long straight roads.
We got good long straight roads.
Yeah.
We got some great toll roads too that are not heavily traveled on. I'm tempted just to drive this thing back. You had a couple of Carrera Porsches too, right? Twin cam cars?
Yep.
How many of those have you found?
The last one I found was a twin cam, and the engine was out and all in pieces. And I put a regular 1600 in it, and it broke the crankshaft. And so I was kind of concerned. He says, "Well, don't worry, I've got a crankshaft for it." And I got to the guy's house, and I looked at all the parts, and I said, "Okay, where's the crankshaft?" And he went over to this big bucket. He put rubber gloves on. Dipped his hands down in and came out. He had left it in an oil bucket.
That's so
wouldn't
what he
rust,
made.
Wouldn't corrode.
Smart.
This thing's like gold. I said, yeah, I think it is. I've got a hill climb car. It's got a four cam engine.
You still have that?
Yeah, I still got it.
That's really cool. Yeah, I've seen you
going to Goodwood.
That's really cool.
Yeah, Lord March. I was just with him a few weeks ago in Newport, Rhode Island, and I told him about the car. He says, yeah. Send me some information. I'd like you to come to the hill climb. So,
Goodwood's on my bucket list. I've never been.
Yeah, but I haven't either. So this is
really.
Yeah.
Have you done Isle of Man?
No. Matter of fact, I'm wearing my vest right now, but I have an Isle of Man a jacket that I wear all the time.
I'm going this year.
All right. Oh yep. My God, I'd love to go.
You got it all set up.
We're going back and do the London to Brighton. I bought a 1901 Olds, so we'll go do that. You can just park over here anywhere.
Well, that was an experience. Thank you for that.
It was great. Thanks for driving.
How'd it go?
Oh, it's outstanding.
Yeah. He rocked on it a couple of times. It's cool, yeah.
It's
it takes off.
It's faster than I thought it was going to be.
620 horsepower.
It's fast.
Yeah. Especially with those superchargers wind up, make that squealing noise.
The wheels look like a turbo fan.
Yep.
All right, I'll take it.
You're good?
Thank you.
All right.
I'll wire you the money. You've got my email.
Yep.
You just send that to me. I'll get it over here today.
Perfect.
That's great.
Thank you.
Can I see your 72?
Yeah.
All right. So I was telling Wayne, Mike, I've been collecting long hood Porsches for quite a while.
Okay.
I have 65 all the way up to 73 and a half.
Oh, wow.
The only car I don't have is a 72. And I for some reason, I cannot find it.
This is a good one.
I mean, I have looked and looked and looked. The only ones I've found are just crazy rough. I don't really want to do another.
So I tried to buy this car 3 years ago.
I got a
deal made with the guy, sent him the money, and he sent the money back, said I can't do it.
That's what happened to me 6 months ago on one.
Really?
A gold car. Nice original car, and I love that car, gold. I sent him the money and sent it back.
Yeah. Then he called me about, a month and a half ago. He says, okay, I'm finally ready.
Well, this is
the best original car probably you'll ever see. This is a 7,000 mile 54 Commander Starliner Coupe that is totally, totally, totally original.
Original paint.
Tires I changed, but I have the original tires.
Is that coral?
Well, it's called a red, but it is coral. But one owner, one driver. In order to even, look at the condition of the seats, everything. This is an amazing, amazing car.
What is this to the right?
Altimeter. He lived in Pittsburgh, where there's a lot of hills, so he put an altimeter in there.
Yeah, I'd be kidding. That was the first thing I noticed. Like, what is that?
Yeah.
That is really neat.
Yeah.
Great color combination.
Isn't it unbelievable?
Yeah. I've never seen one that nice.
And a lot of guys go crazy. So these hubcaps, but they offer these spinners as an accessory. And every Studebaker guy looks and he says, I've seen him in pictures, but I've never, unbelievable to see him on a car, especially a car with all these things on. It's got a hood ornament, which was an accessory that nobody put him on, but this guy did. Wow. Just all cool stuff. Hey, if you figure what cars looked like in 1954, you know, what a Chrysler looked like, or a Chevy or a Ford,
mm-hmm.
and there were boxes. And now you look at this car.
Oh, the styling is amazing.
Everything's laying back. This movement is already going, you know?
This has got to be the coolest V8 emblem I've ever seen.
Isn't that great? Yeah. that great?
They did all have that, did they?
Yes.
They did? Okay.
Yeah. Wow. Well, the V8 cars, they also made these in sixes.
That emblem was amazing.
Yeah.
Well, the condition is incredible. I love original stuff.
So this is going down to the Savoy Museum. The only reason I'm even letting it out of my sight is Ken Gross asked me.
Okay.
And I said, and he said, can I please have your car for the display? And I said, okay. So it's going down there for the whole winter.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
All right. Here's good stuff. Some more good stuff.
So got the 911 up there on the lift.
Is that polo red?
No.
What? It looks a little bit pinkish. Cool color.
I'll have to check the window sticker. I have all the documentation.
You have the window sticker for it?
Oh, yeah. Everything. Car.
He bought it new in 72.
So I asked him. He calls me. He says, it's all original. I said, really? So send me pictures. And so he sends me pictures. I said, that paint is original? Oh, no, I had to repaint it. I said, well, then it's not all original. He says, did you expect it to have the original oil in it? Did you expect it to have the original tires? I said, no. He says, well, paint goes bad after a while. I said, no, it really doesn't. He says, well, it was getting a little faded. I left it outside in the sun, you know, during the day. I drive it to work and leave it outside in the sun. But I got to let it down. You got to see the interior. It's nuts how nice it is.
That just showed. A York's compressor just barely fits in there.
I know.
Still got the original MFI on it, too.
Yep.
It's amazing how many these are converted to Webers.
Look at that turn.
Wow, dashing even cracked.
No crack, nothing, no.
And a straight up coupe.
Yep.
Which is what everybody wants. Yep. It's amazing how much the sunroof and or a Targa affects the value. Mm-hmm. I mean, this is what everybody wants.
Yeah. That's right. And 1 year for this, that was it. And then they said, wait a minute, everybody's spilling oil all over the side of the car. I guess it's maybe not a good idea.
People were putting gas in it.
Yeah.
And wiping the motors out.
Yeah.
That was a really bad idea from Porsche.
Yeah.
Cool though. That's beautiful. Yeah. Well, if that's ever for sale, let me know.
Okay.
I do not have a 72.
Well, we're gonna do an engine out service. Got a few oil lines that are leaking, so might as well drop it out, detail everything in here, reseal it all, because that's what you got to do with older Porsches, just reseal it.
Oh, they leak so bad.
Yeah.
I've got three right now that we've got the motors out.
Well, you can see by the exhaust over there, I mean, look at how oily the exhaust is. You
know, well, I mean, if they sit for a long time, too, the actual muffler will just, the oil just goes in the muffler.
So there's that Edwards I was speaking to you about. Let's get ready. That's going to Pebble this coming year. And I got a GT500 KR.
That's a big car.
Yeah.
Edwards is bigger than I thought it would be.
Yeah. I'm doing a 190 here. 275. Wow. I just did the interior on this. Got the engine out being rebuilt.
Yeah, that's really cool.
So 1951, this has to be one of the first fiberglass cars ever made.
Yeah, that and the Woodall Wildfire.
Yep, Woodall Wildfire.
I've had several of those.
And the fiberglass is so heavy and so thick.
I mean, that's crazy. You know,
they weren't saving weight, I can tell you that, by doing
fiberglass. Have you ever restored an early Corvette?
Oh, yeah.
That's a nightmare.
Yeah, we've got one up in the back.
Total nightmare.
Yeah, we'll take it up in the back building.
It just takes so much time.
And this is the Cadillac Valkyrie, Brooke Stevens car. I don't know if you ever saw this, but it's white and black. It's got a huge V bumper on the front.
No, I've never seen this.
Yeah, it's called the Valkyrie. So this is going to Villa d'Este in 23.
So is this a prototype?
Yes, he just built it, and then he showed it all around the world. So he showed it at every auto show all over the world. Went to Paris. You know, the English show, it just
Earl's Court.
Yeah.
Earl's Court, yeah.
It was shown every auto show in the world. Los Angeles, Detroit, New York. And all of his cars were always painted white and black. And this was his wife's car. He built it and gave it to her. And she drove it.
boy, that's a lot of work.
She drove it in the winters in Minnesota, and all the quarter panels and rockers were just totally rotted out to nothing.
So how many hours is this going to be?
Oh, this is a long time.
Thousands?
Yeah, but
people just don't realize how much work this is. That's a lot.
It's all coming together. Now. The frame is all done, and all the suspension, all that stuff is done. You can see how it's dusty, but everything's put together now, so it's just a matter of pulling the body back off now, everything fits.
It looks like you got several years of work in the shop now.
Oh. Besides my own stuff.
We're booked further out now than we ever have been in the history of my company. Yeah. And we don't want to restore Jeeps.
Well, we're busy, that's for sure. And I've been sneaking my own projects in too, so.
My general manager won't let me do that anymore.
Do you have your keys with us so we can get in the upper building?
I don't. I'll run next door.
Yeah, I don't have mine. Oh, no, I left mine in my other jacket. So I got to show you this picture. So before I bought that, had the opportunity to buy that Studebaker.
Mm-hmm.
I was in an auction 2 years beforehand, and I bought that.
No way.
I did. You think it was meant to be?
Absolutely.
That I found that car?
That's really cool.
Isn't that unbelievable?
Yeah.
Let's go into the museum with the car.
Wow.
Yeah, that's a good car. The only difference is the top. It's a different color, that's it.
The 330 in there?
Yeah, 330. That's my car. Just sold it midway through the restoration.
I love the 330.
They're great.
I really do. Yeah. I mean, that's...
Yeah, I've had that for a long time, that car.
They're finally getting their... some recognition.
That's right.
So spiders really got expensive.
I'll show you. We have a spider too.
Do you really?
Yeah.
Wow.
This is our interior shop. So Quid just finished doing this little hot rod for a buddy of mine. So we did all nice leather seats, new top.
Is the only thing that we send out, period, is powder coat for the frame, mm-hmm, and interior. Is it worth having your own interior shop here?
Yeah.
It's the only thing I've never done.
Because we always ship the car out and it came back with damage every time. They sit in there, and so sometimes it would take 6-8 months to do interior.
And then you're doing paintwork again.
He brings it in here and he works on one car at a time and that's it.
Boom. I'm seriously considering it. I mean, what we do is the same stuff over and over.
This has been done. We're just waiting for chrome to come back, but that's all been done. You can see that the interior, that beautiful brown color.
That's the about the color of a 73.5 911.
Uh-huh.
Oh, these are great cars.
Yep. This is an all original 57 wagon.
How many acres do you have?
This here is 2.5 acres.
2.5 months? Yeah, I'm on 2 acres. About similar size.
Yeah. I'll take you up to my farm if you got time.
Absolutely. Okay. It's up to you.
Okay. So this is a mixture here of cars in for service as well as cars for sale.
Love the Alpha. That sounds awesome.
Yeah, that's got the motor out of that. Got blew a head gasket and kept driving.
This was a long, 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 long time ago, but I think I sold the first one of these that broke $100,000.
Is that right?
I sold one to Barrett Jackson like more than 20 years ago.
Oh, wow. Nice Buick over there. So I get that Buick that comes in. So I have an autistic daughter.
Okay.
Kimberly's now 33, but Rayman movie was just very special to me.
Right.
And so one day this car comes in on a truck and it's half a part, and the lady calls me and she says, we need an estimate on it. And I said, so I give her the estimate. I said, this looks just like the Rain Man car. It's really kind of spooky. She goes, that's because it is.
No way.
Yeah. She says, it's the car that was driven in the movie. And the guy that owns it is Barry Levinson. He was the director of the movie.
Okay. Yeah, I know who he is.
And he picked this car specifically because he grew up in Baltimore. And he'd sit out on the front stoop of the house every night and see the cars go by. And the neighbor down the street, this doctor, had a 49 Buick. And he said, that's the car we're going to use in the movie.
He's even got the license plate. This is Rain Man.
Yep.
That's the actual car.
That's it. So the story is really great. So we restore the car for him. I take to his house and put it in the garage. And it's not the right garage, I don't think, to keep the car. So I make a deal with him. I said, why don't I keep the car? And when you want to use it, I'll bring it to you.
Okay.
has never seen the car. It's been 10 years since we really started. He's never seen it. So I made the deal. I store it for free, but I get to use it to promote autism charities.
That's fantastic.
Yeah, so we take it all over the country, show it in different
locations. What's the name of your charity?
Autism Families Connecticut.
Okay.
But we give to autism families all over the country. So if I'm giving a talk in Florida, we pick an autism family there. I'm not into the larger charities like Autism Speaks, because really there's so much money traveling around and I want to know where my money's going.
Yeah, I agree.
So, yeah, it's cool. We didn't do the interior because he says, don't do that. He says, Dustin Hoffman and Tom Cruise sat in that car.
Can I sit in it?
Sure.
Wow.
That was sweet.
It's got to be one of the most iconic movie cars of all
time.
It
is, by far. Because I think that this car became a character in the movie.
Agreed.
Just like the people.
I can't even imagine what this car's worth. It's a big number.
I've been trying to buy it from him, but he says no.
That is really cool.
Isn't that cool?
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome.
That's neat. Really cool. Man, you tackle some big projects, sir.
Wow.
That is so much work doing an American convertible like that.
This is an all-original 61 Caddy. Amazing car.
Beautiful color.
Yeah, isn't that great?
Yeah. Oh, you do have a early bet.
Yep.
Pennant blue.
Pennant blue.
The 54.
Yep. A little bit of everything. That's that Falcon I was telling you about.
This is a lightweight front bumper on it.
Yep. It's got a plastic front bumper, rear.
Does it have a Thunderbolt hood on it too?
No. But the guy set it up for basically touring. So it's got a 348.
So 302 out to 348.
Oh, that's unbelievable.
And you're keeping that one for yourself?
Roll cage. Oh, yeah, that's my car.
That's neat.
Yeah.
One night
there's another. There's a 330 GTC.
Love it. It's a great color.
So we were servicing a 330 GTC, and the guy comes up, and I just bought this car. And he said, would you paint that color? That car yellow for me if I bought it from him? I said, yeah. So we bought it, painted it yellow. He passed away, bought it from his estate. We sold that car 4 times.
And it still hasn't left.
It's still here.
Is that fly yellow?
Yes.
Yeah.
It's still here.
What color is the interior?
It's a black interior. Yeah.
Original, right?
Yeah. It's all original.
190s are still doing well.
Yeah. This is one that we just painted for a gentleman, and we've got the carburetors out right now, being restored.
I haven't bought a 190 in a while. Last year I found quite a few.
Well, this year, beautiful cars to look at, but a little slow.
Oh, they are so underpowered.
Yeah.
E-type Jag.
There's another Allard. This is a Caddy Allard, 331. It's just the wrong color, I think personally, but
it's kind of odd.
If it was gray. You know, with
originally
black wall tires and painted wheels, silver wheels or something like that.
And definitely needs to go back to that.
Yeah, it'd be beautiful.
Just fabulous stuff everywhere.
Yeah.
104 up there. Is that 100M or 104?
Just a 4. Yep. We got another Dino over there. We restored this Dino, I don't know, it's going on 20 years. We bought it back. It belonged to the Kittredge family, which was the Yankee Candle.
And, factory black car?
Yeah, factory black car.
That's unusual,
yeah,
isn't it?
Very unusual. I bought that from Michael Sheehan. The only reason I bought it was black.
Have you seen the one running around that's got the F40 motor in it?
No, somebody told me about it, though. It says there's some guy that's doing and putting 308s and 328 engines in it, too.
Yeah. The one with the F4, if you saw it, I mean, this is...
The Evo, you, David Lee.
It's unbelievable. I mean,
you've seen it, I haven't seen
it. If you saw one, what you've seen in person, you'll probably build one. It's that cool. Have you seen it?
Not in person. I follow them on online.
It's just
online.
Insanely cool. Yeah, these are so underpowered.
Yeah. Well...
Beautiful car.
They're beautifully powered, though. Just enough to have fun with it. Not get in trouble.
True that. I guess it's not like a 190 that's just crazy underpowered, but...
And this is I love these things. 63 and a half sprints. Beautiful. I mean, the lines of that car. It's like a miniature Galaxy 500.
Is that a 260 car?
It's a 260 badge car. Okay. They put a 302 in it.
Okay.
But it looks just like a 260.
Right.
I mean, painted, you never know.
Because they didn't put the 289s until 65, right?
Right.
I love the Heelys. I've done Heelys my whole life.
Yeah, that's a nice one. And so probably the most strange car in here, you'd look around and you'd say, what are you doing with a Volvo station wagon?
So what are you doing with a Volvo station wagon?
That's the ex-Paul Newman 302 V8 5-speed.
Wow.
Kenny Bell supercharger car. So Paul Newman had three of those cars built, one for himself, one for David Letterman, and one for his accountant. I've repaired David Letterman's car a few times, and so I found out that this one was for sale, and I chased it down to Maryland and bought it.
That's really cool.
Yeah, so that's a cool car.
Did you ever race against him or see him race?
No, I saw him race a lot. I mean, that's where he was.
Amazing, buddy.
Oh, yeah, and he's a great guy. Super, super guy. I actually personally met him at a pizza place about 20 miles from here.
I talked to some of the Porsche team drivers that used to run against him. You know, he beat him.
Yeah.
They just said he was just an amazing driver.
He was.
That's really cool.
Amazing driver, amazing man. That's for sure.
So that 104's got disc brakes on it.
Yeah, it's a converted car. I mean, you know, good driver. It was a good friend of mine's car, actually. I forgot it was here until you just mentioned it. John, get your car out of here.
Yeah. I've got the Earl's Court show car, Goldie, the 58 car. And that car has got four-wheel disc brakes on it from the factory. It was the only road-going car that had the Dunlop race brakes.
Wow.
It's a neat car.
Yeah, they're neat cars, that's for sure. Especially the windshield folds down. It's absolutely gorgeous.
Yeah, that's a great car.
Yeah.
Undervalued,
yeah,
I think, for what they are.
You can get an M. I mean, they're getting up there 100, 125, 150.
But to me, it costs that to restore one, right?
I know. You got to buy one. We sold the all original one. Oh my God, that thing was so original. I think we got 165 or 170 for it.
That's good.
At Bottoms. Yeah, it was like 4 or 5 years ago.
It's like the Longland 911s. I still think they're undervalued because you can't do a proper restoration on one for 100 grand.
Right.
But yet you can buy one for a really nice car for 125, 130.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I'm just wondering when that market's going to move. When that market's going to move.
But
hard to say.
So, car's incredible. Thank you for that. Thanks for holding it.
Oh, you're welcome.
Appreciate it. Thanks for the tour. I got to see his private collection, his house, which is absolutely breathtaking.
Thank you. Thank you.
It's my third time to be at your shop. It's always an honor to be here and an honor to know you, actually.
Well, it's an honor to know you, too.
And I've asked a lot of questions today.
Yeah.
I got one more.
Yeah.
What's your favorite local place to eat?
Farrell's, right up the street.
And would you join us?
Yeah.
All right.
Let's go do it.
I'm going to jump in the Jeep and we'll see you up there.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
I'd like an ice water.
Okay, I'm going to have the
fish and chips.
Fish and chips, okay. For you, sir?
Can I do the clam chowder, please?
Cup or bowl?
Bowl, please.
Okay.
Is that your only soup for today's clam?
And French onion.
And French onion.
Yeah.
Well, since we're up in the Northeast, I'm from Texas.
Can you look on the back?
Yes, ma'am.
Some people don't even see that whole page.
We don't really have much chowder around the Dallas area, so I will try that. I'll start off with that.
Cup or bowl?
Just a cup.
Okay.
And Mike says you're somewhat famous for your Reuben.
Yes, it's very good.
I'll do the Reuben.
Okay, French fries good with that? Or you can substitute a salad or coleslaw.
Salad.
Or for a slight upcharge, we have onion rings, tater tots, sweet potato fries.
How about a salad and blue cheese?
Okay, sounds good.
I'm going to have a CBLT wrap.
Okay.
And I don't think it has onions, but no onions, please,
okay.
Just in case.
And French fries?
No, nothing.
Okay, you can do a salad or coleslaw.
Coleslaw.
Okay.
That's perfect.
All right.
Clam chowder. I don't know the last time I had this.
It's a New England thing to do.
Really good. It's kind of a staple here, right?
It is.
Powder. There you go. Fish and chips. Excuse me, leaning over. You got it? Okay. CBLT wrap here.
Yes, ma'am.
There you go.
And this is the lunch portion.
That's a dinner portion must be amazing.
Anyway. Here you go. Casserole dish is very hot.
And the world famous Reuben.
Yes, sir.
Right.
Wow.
Thank you, ma'am. Anybody anything? Another Diet Coke?
Yes,
sure.
Please.
Okay, I'll come over there and grab it.
Thank you.
Check that out.
Be right back. Enjoy your meals.
Thank you. So? Okay.
It is outstanding.
Okay, good.
Wow. So Farrell's, Portland, Connecticut, not Oregon. Clam chowder and a beautiful Reuben. Hot, cheesy. I think it's Thousand Island dressing. So Best Bite in the middle.
What's that? Is this a food channel?
It is now.
Perfect. Good food, good friends, good fun.
Right.
Well, Wayne, Sue, and Mike, thank you for your time.
Thank you.
The hospitality.
It was great to have you here.
Shop's amazing. Thanks for holding the SLR for me. Actually, for my brother James. Thanks for all the phone calls.
And you buy a car, you come anytime you want. Every time you just buy a car, we're all set. I'll even pay for lunch next time.
Well, I tell you what, as soon as the engine out service is done in that 72, give me a call.
All right,
we're arm wrestle over that.
All right.
Y'all have a great day.
Thanks, you too.
All right. Boom, we're back in Dallas. We left yesterday at 1 o'clock. It's now 9 p.m. It was a long day, but it was a great trip. Went to F40 Motorsports, met with Mr. Wayne Carini, the legend, the god, father of supercars and classic cars, and actually bought a 2008 Mercedes McLaren SLR. It got to tour his shop. What an honor. I hope you guys enjoyed as much as I did. Please like, tag, share, and follow. Subscribe to our YouTube channel. See you next week.